Okay, so good morning students, myself Chandra Mohan, working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Okay, so today my topic is special functions. Special function. So already you know that you heard about algebraic functions. Okay, so trigonometric functions, exponential functions, hyperbolic functions, so like that. So we have some special functions. So in special functions, so we have beta function, and second one is gamma function. Okay, so gamma function. So today we are going to learn about these two special functions. So first one is beta function and second one is gamma function. So apart from this, we have some more special functions, but in our syllabus we have about these two functions only, beta function and gamma function. Okay, so now coming to the first one, beta function. So definition, so an integral 0 to 1, definite integral 0 to 1, x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx. Okay, so a definite integral, so 0 to the limits belongs to 0 to 1, so x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx. So this is called beta function and it is denoted by beta m comma n, read as beta m comma n. It is denoted by b of m comma n. So that is b of m comma n is equal to the definite integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx. Okay, so read as beta. So and it is converges when m comma n greater than 0. So where both m comma n should be positive. Okay, so then only this definite integral will converge. Okay, so that is beta m comma n is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx. So now let us discuss about the properties of beta function. Okay, so we have some properties of beta function. So now we let us discuss properties. So the first property is symmetry property. Symmetry. Okay, so symmetry property is beta m comma n is equal to beta n comma m. So that is called symmetry property of beta function. So now let us derive this symmetry property. Okay, so now as you know the definition of the beta function, so what is the definition of beta function? So beta of m comma n is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx, right? Okay, so we know that the definition of beta function, that is beta m comma n is equal to integral, definite integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx. Here the integration with respect to x. Okay, and these limits belongs to x only. Now, so to prove this symmetry property, so we are using here substitution method. Okay, so let put 1 minus x is equal to some y or some other variable. Okay, so I am putting 1 minus x is equal to y. Okay, so then x becomes what? X is equal to 1 minus y. And here the limits, the definite integral limits belongs to x. So but here we are putting 1 minus x is equal to y. So we need to find y limits. Okay, so now if x is equal to 0, so if x is equal to 0, lower limit, corresponding y limit is what? 1 minus 0. Put x is equal to 0 in this. So then y becomes 1 minus 0 means 1. So that is lower limit. Okay? So So now if x is equal to upper limit, take upper limit 1, so we get corresponding lower, y limit. So that is, if x is equal to 1, y becomes 0. Now the limits from 1 to 0. Okay, so take these new limits. Now beta m comma n is equal to integer. Now the new limits become 1 to 0, these limits belongs to y, so y is equal to 1 to 0, and put x, x is what, 1 minus y, so 1 minus y, and put 1 minus x is equal to y, y to the power n minus 1, and dx. So what is dx? Differentiate on both sides, then you will get dx is equal to 1 derivative 0, 0 minus y derivative dy, so dx is equal to, you get minus dy. So put also dx is equal to minus dy. Okay, so here the limit belongs to y, and here the integration with respect to y only. Okay, so now, so this is equal to integral y is equal to 1 to 0, so take minus out, and y to the power n minus 1, 1 minus y to the power m minus 1 into dy. Okay, now you can write this, if you remove this minus, so you can change the limits, so y is equal to 0 to 1. Okay, so y to the power n minus 1 and 1 minus y to the power m minus 1 dy. Now by using the definition of beta function, so you can written this as, so beta of m comma m, you can write it as beta of n comma m. So since beta of m comma n is equal to, so integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx, right? So by using this definition we are writing here, so integral 0 to 1 y to the power n minus 1, 1 minus y to the power m minus 1 dy is equal to beta of n comma m. Okay, so finally beta of m comma n is equal to beta of n comma m. Okay, so this is called symmetry property. Okay, so this is first property, and coming to the second property. Okay, so now beta of m comma n is equal to, so 2 into integral 0 to pi by 2, so x to the power 2m minus 1 theta, y to the power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. So that is second property of beta function. So now we are going to do a proof. Okay, so by definition of beta function, so beta m comma n is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx. Okay, so now put x is equal to sine square theta. We are using substitution method, so for that we are substituting x is equal to sine square theta. Okay, so if x is equal to sine square theta, then dx, differentiate on both sides, then dx is equal to what, 2 into sine theta, and sine theta derivative cos theta, and theta derivative d theta. Okay, so final dx is equal to sine theta cos theta into d theta. So now the limits also will change. So for x is equal to 0, if x is equal to 0, no limit, so find corresponding theta value, so that is theta becomes 0, sine 0 is equal to 0, if x is 0, sine 0 is 0. Okay, so now if x is equal to pi by 2, so upper limit, taking upper limit, so find corresponding theta value, so theta is equal, if x is equal to pi by 2, theta becomes, sine pi by 2 is 1, so theta is equal to 1. Okay, so now substituting definition of beta function, so that is beta m comma n is equal to integral. Okay, so now write the theta limits, theta is equal to 0 to 1. Okay, so now x, what is x, x is here sine square theta, put that साइन स्क्वायर थीटा होल टू द पावर एम माइनस वन एंड वन माइनस एक्स. व्हाट इज एक्स? साइन स्क्वायर थीटा. साइन स्क्वायर थीटा होल टू द पावर एन माइनस वन एंड dx. dx इज टू साइन थीटा cos थीटा इंटू d थीटा. ओके, सो टू साइन थीटा cos थीटा d थीटा. नाउ सो बीटा एम कॉमा एन इज इक्वल टू इंटीग्रल थीटा इज इक्वल टू जीरो टू वन साइन स्क्वेयर थीटा होल टू दी पावर एम माइनस वन मीन साइन टू दी पावर साइन टू दी पावर टू एम माइनस टू थीटा एंड वन माइनस साइन स्क्वेयर थीटा इज कॉस स्क्वेयर थीटा. सो कॉस स्क्वेयर थीटा होल टू दी पावर एन माइनस वन टू एम माइनस टू थीटा into 2. So you can take common, you can take out 2 into sin theta cos theta into d theta. So this is equal to 2 into 0 to 1 new limit 0 to 1. So sin power 2m minus 2 sin theta is sin power 2m minus 1 theta. And cos power 2n minus 2 and cos to the power 1. Cos to the power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. So this is beta of m comma n. Okay. So 2 into, you can also write it as 1 by 2 beta of m comma n is equal to integral 0 to 1 sin to the power 2m minus 1 theta cos to the power 2n minus 1 theta d theta. So this is another property of beta function. Now coming to the third property. So third property is beta of m comma n is equal to beta of m plus 1 comma n plus beta of m comma n plus 1. Okay, so that is the third property of beta function. So now let us derive this. So already we know that the definition of beta function. So beta of m comma n is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx. Okay, so now beta, take this term beta of m plus 1 comma n. So that is beta of m plus 1 comma n. So put m is equal to m plus 1. So you will get 0 to 1 x to the power. So replace m by m plus 1. M plus 1 minus 1. And 1 minus x to the power. N is n only. 1 minus x all to the power n minus 1 into dx. So this is equal to integral 0 to 1 x to the power plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled. So x to the power m into 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 into dx. So that is about beta of m plus 1 comma n. Now take the second term. So that is beta of m comma n plus 1. So that is equal to integral 0 to 1. So put n is equal to n plus 1. So in the definition, so you will get x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n plus 1 minus 1 dx. So this is equal integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1, 1 minus x to the power n into dx. Okay, so now you can add these two. Okay, so that is now take beta of m plus 1 comma n plus beta of m comma n plus 1. Okay, RHS, take RHS. So that is integral 0 to 1 x to the power m 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 dx and plus integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 1 1 minus x all to the power n into dx. Okay, now add these two. So take common integral 0 to 1 x to the power m 1 minus x to the power n minus 1 Okay, so x to the power m 1 minus x to the power or n minus 1 plus x. 1 minus x over to the power n minus 1 common. 1 plus 1 minus x. 1 minus x n minus 1 plus 1 n into dx. X to the power m 1 minus x over to the power 4. Okay. So you will get here integral 0 to 1 x to the power m minus 4, right? X to the power m minus 1 1 minus x whole to the power n minus 1 dx. So that is equal to beta of m comma n. So finally, so we proved. Okay, thank you.